all we're going to do is make a big reflector out of a single box. I'm going to do the same thing with this one, but I'm not going to leave the sections connected. You'll see what I mean in a minute. Okay, I'm about half done. Now you can do this with glue too. I just decided to use tape, but glue or tape, whatever you got. I'll run a third sheet down the middle. That looks pretty good to me. Now all we gotta do is set it up. Okay, let's take another look here. It's been about a half an hour. I guess you can see that's pretty bright right there. Sun's really coming in strong right now. I think I'm going blind just looking at that. Should probably be wearing sunglasses. Let's take a look and see what kind of temperature we got here. Right about 210 or so. I'm not sure if you can see that. It's dropping fast. That's about 210 to 215. It's almost exactly what I thought I'd get. That's awesome. So there it is, single box covered in three long sheets of aluminum foil. Bend it in a semicircle, point it towards the sun, and use this pot-in-pot design. So the only insulation on this thing is the actual the pot inside the pot. You can see I painted it black to get the highest heat possible. So there you go. That's about the simplest solar oven I can think of to make. Any sort of material like this covered in a shiny surface like aluminum foil or aluminized mylar, even mirrors in a semicircle. And the main thing is you want to get a pan, like a thick ceramic style pan for the inside pot, and the outside pot should be glass, as clear as glass as possible. This happens to be a Pyrex pot with a glass lid and a clay terracotta style pot for the inside with just a little bit of airspace around the edge. It's still sticking around 200 and the lid's not even on. Let's put this back on and check it in a little bit. I am going to switch the reflector to the other style, see what kind of temps we can get out of that. I've already cut this one into four sections, so this is the box. These are the four sections it turns into. Okay, there's the completed reflector oven. Okay, here's the other reflector. It's just the four individual pieces kind of set in a semicircle. That's basically it. But this is definitely another good option. One cardboard box, one roll of tinfoil, some tape, and or glue. Strongly recommend just leaving the box together like that. If anyone can think of even a simpler solar oven than this, let me know. Love to see it. Hey, this is just a quick update here. I wanted to show both of the ovens combined, just one option if you wanted to make both of these and use them at the same time. Something like that, set up facing south, you could probably get enough sun hitting that pot all day so you wouldn't have to move it even once. And something like that would be, as you can see, that's going to reflect a lot of sunlight onto the pan.